The Duff. Oh, yeah, baby. I remember the Duff. He was the lead guitarist in a dark core metal band I had called Purple Panther back in the early 80s. We were gigantic, man, playing stadiums, touring the world from Eastern Slovakia to Baklavia to Batlava. We were just freaking huge, man, till he met that damn girl. What was her name? Oh, yeah, Denice Burker. Because he just outright left. He did a Jim Morrison on us and disappeared. Who knows, man? Last I heard, he moved to California, changed his name to Michael, and even grew a beard. But what do I know? Still, the Duff, love him, baby. The Duff.
Well, that Michael Duff, I mean, you know, what can you say? But the guy is a goddamn tornado of talent, and I'm not a swearing woman. Forgive me. God forgive me. But seriously, this man, you cannot share the stage with him. I mean, if you do, just go home. You know, just close the club and go home and pack your shit, because there is no point. The guy is a goddamn... I'm sorry, Lord. I'm just... This is Michael Duff. Okay? I think you understand.
Hello. My name is Esmeralda Jimenez Tijerina Martinez Guadalupe de Tre. Anyway, I heard that it is Mr. Michael Duff's birthday, and I want to say that the first time that I met Michael was when I was cleaning the hotel room when you were on the tour with the chalk farm, naughty, naughty boys. The stuff that I had to clean out of the freaking hotel room. Ay chingada, you know? It was so much. It was stuff that I vowed never to speak of before in Guadalupe, Santa Maria. Even though I had to clean up after you boys, and you know what you did. Michael Duff's stuff was the most cleanest out of everybody. And also, he left a little tip for me. Not going to say what I had to lift up to get to the tip, but I was very happy. Anyway, feliz cumpleaños, Miguel. I hope you have a wonderful day. And you tell a beautiful wife, Denicia, that I promise never to tell her what happened in the hotel room. Okay, bye-bye.
Look at this thing, I'm clicking, nothing's happening. You see, I click and nothing happens. Then it freezes, this circle. So I'm trying to get, sometimes I can't even get Google, come on, you know?
Michael Duff. He's got the stuff. He's really tough, and that beard makes him look gruff. And he's just good enough. Cause he's Michael Duff. Shit, is this on? Happy birthday, Michael Duff. You wrote me a song for my birthday, so there's your song. It's copyrighted and certain restrictions apply. Happy birthday.
I first met Michael in Vegas at the Chalk Farm concert, and he introduced me to his twin brother, Timmy. It was love at first sight.
Kiss me!
I gotta go.
H-B-T-Y, H-B-E-T-Y, H-B-T-D-A-M, H-B-E-T-Y. That's happy birthday to you, Michael! These old ladies own the copyrights to that, so we're not actually allowed to sing the happy birthday song, but I'm just saying happy big 5-0! As you can tell, I'm in front of the Grand Ole Opry. I'm doing the opening number tonight. I'm so thrilled. But my success goes all the way back 20-some years ago when Michael was my vocal coach. We started off by singing, this song is still a hit. You can look it up. If love were a rowboat, I'm drowning, please throw me an oar. I just want to say, Michael, I'm so proud of you. You are such a treasure. It's my love to you, my dear sweet boy. And thank you, Denice, also for his very soft lips.
Well, Michael Duff, being as this year, November 6th, Election Day fell on your birthday, your wife reached out to me that I give you a personalized birthday wish. And let me tell you, it does not take a politician to know that you are a true leader in your community. I hear you could see Alaska from your bedroom.
This is Rosanna Sanchez reporting live from the hills of the San Fernando Valley in a clandestine location where
ping pong champions Jim Meskimen and Dror Soref are training with the infamous Greta Van Streusel. Oh yes, this is serious, folks. They are here in an effort to beat the one and only Duff.
Achtung! Hello, my name is Greta. I will be your personal trainer. But first, you must submit to my terms. Is this agreed?
Yes!
I understand that you want to beat Duff. Is this true?
Yes, beat Duff!
Beat Duff!
Good! I can get you there! Mach schnell! Light as a feather! It feels light as a feather! Yes, it feels light as a feather! Mach schnell! Mach schnell! Reverse! Mach schnell! Mach schnell! Faster! The ping pong ball can be your friend or your enemy. Which will it be? Mach schnell! Mach schnell!
She's tough. Greta's really tough, but if there's anybody that can get Dror and I back in shape to beat Duff, it's Greta. Well, now, I'm coming. Excuse me.
Visualize!
Beat Duff!
Will they win, or will Duff always be victorious? We shall see in the next go-around. This is Rosanna Sanchez reporting live.
There will never be Duff. Damn.
Beat Duff!
Oh, yeah. Woo! Oh, yeah, man, Duff. Fuck yeah. Nah, he was one of my students, man. Absolutely, I remember him. Only guy I knew could survive on Wonder Bread, Cheese Whiz, and Carney's hamburgers and still give 100% in the gym. Guy was an animal. Whew, man. Never touched a vegetable. I think he was allergic to them. Hated them. But I'll tell you what. Sinewy dude, you know? Like fucking cheetah-like. Just in an unassuming way that made you think twice about ever fucking with this guy. But now, man, ah, shit. You got those memories flooding back on me, man. Whoa. We share some great times in the gym, you know? Just real man-to-man connection, if you know what I mean. Just, we shared moments I think touched us both in ways that we never thought possible. Shit. Bring back some memories, my friend, huh? Take a look. Welcome to the gun show, my friend. Huh? Happy birthday, buddy.
Of the enemy and weaknesses. So let's just list them out. Okay, let's list his strengths, okay? He is 7 feet tall.
Yep.
He can jump 10 feet above the ground. Can sing songs. He can write songs. He's like a rock star. Those are his strengths. No problem. Now we list out all of his weaknesses. No, he has no weaknesses. Okay, back to the book. Well, I'm sure there's a section that says if the enemy's really good, there's a way to trick him. If the general of the troops is too nice to the troops, if he likes them too much, if he's too nice a guy, it's a weakness. We can beat him because he's a nice guy. We will trick him into being nice.
Booyah! I'll beat you, spank you, got you! 15 zip, Mr. Volleyball Man, in your face.
I can't shut it off. I can't even shut the button off. I don't know, Michael. I don't know what I'm supposed to type in here.
Hello. Good evening. I'm Sir Reginald Osgood Smath. I am the founder and director of the Royal Scottish Chamber Symphony. And I am here this evening to wish Mr. Michael Duff the most happiest of birthdays. You might wonder how I know Mr. Duff. Well, years ago, when I was tasked with forming the symphony orchestra, I had to travel all over the world seeking the finest players. Of course, we started in Scotland, but we could never find a violist that could meet our high standards. So I went to the colonies, to the northeast, and I heard a rumor of a tremendous violist named Michael Duff. I searched him out. I found him playing on the streets, playing songs by Peter, Paul, and Mary. But he had a fantastic tone and quite a prestigious technique. So I brought him to Scotland and he auditioned and he became our principal violist. After a glorious first season, he went home on a vacation to see his family in the States. I received a note from him. I was heartbroken. He decided to leave the symphony. He went on about four strings weren't enough. He needed six. And he had found something that rocked and rolled. Well, we were devastated. So Mr. Duff, I hope you have enjoyed your adventure with six strings and this rocking and rolling. If you ever wish to return to Scotland, you'll be welcomed with open arms.
There must be like 20 to 30 foot out there. Duff, where are you? You're supposed to be down here. Your scene's up next, man. You're supposed to be pedaling out there with Gerard Butler. We're doing Chasing Mavericks too, okay? And you're starring in this. Oh my God, you just wiped out. Anyway, man. Have a good night, and we'll see you down here tomorrow morning. Happy birthday. Ciao.
Welcome to In-N-Out. My name is Donna. How can I help you? Oh, it's you, Mr. Duff. Would you like your usual? A double single, mustard and ketchup only, fries, and two waters? And a little birdie told me. Happy birthday, Michael. We're so happy for you. Here you go. What are you doing? What are you doing? Well, these are for Michael.
Happy birthday.
Your husband gave me the CD from him, very beautiful voice. And he scored the most beautiful score here. Nobody did it like him. He scored like a professional, heading the ball without a stop, and scored beautiful goals.
Tell us about the game.
It was a tough one today. You know, we went two goals down in the first half and we had to fight back and we did that. We kept possession of the ball. We kept moving around, kept pressing, and we got the three goals that we needed to get the win. And we got the 3 points and I'm pleased with that.
Are you glad Michael Duff transferred into the squad?
Absolutely. You know, I'm glad he left London and came up to a real squad. He's a big guy. He's got a big heart, big passion for the game. He wears these tiny shorts, though. It's funny.
What can you say about Michael Duff's performance today?
Oh, it's fantastic. It's not every day you see a goalkeeper score a hat-trick, is it? Especially against your old club.
You think we'll ever see anything like that again?
Generally, I would say no. I don't think so. I mean, it's kind of impossible, but it's Duff then, isn't it? So I say, yeah, you might.
What were you saying to him walking off the pitch?
I said two things to him, actually. I love you. Happy 50th birthday.
I'd say it's about 92 or 93. And I was in Kansas on my family farm. And these boys come driving through, and they's with the band. I think at the time they was called the Screaming Cheetah Donkeys. And they was gonna play a show, and they needed somebody to come play with them. And on my farm, we was chalk farmers. We raised chalk since it was little, make it big, to use in schoolhouses and on sidewalks. Anyway, these boys is gonna play a show, but they needed another guitar player. And I said, hell, I'll play with you. And they said, okay. And I said, y'all got a crazy name. You should change your name. And Michael said, well, what should we change it to? And I said, well, I'm a chalk farmer. How about the Chalk Farmers? And they said, yeah, okay. And we wrote a bunch of songs together. And we was like best friends. And then one day they said, hey, Cletus, we don't want you in the band no more. And I said, well, fine, you're gonna make me Yoko Ono. You can't have the band name no more. Well, they changed the band name just slightly. Well, I was real proud of those guys and what they did. I was upset I wasn't a part of it, but I just went back on to chalk farming. We got a real successful business. We raising chalk in different colors. Anyway, I wish Michael the best of luck and want to say happy birthday to him. I'd also like to get my banjo back at some point. I think y'all still have that.
I don't know what I'm supposed to type in here. It's just like totally frozen. It's a dangerous warning virus.
Pee-wee, how'd it go last night?
It was incredible. Yep, they sent me this guy, Michael Duff. They said you have to set him on fire. So I brought in my usual fire guys, and we got him all set up. And you know what? I have a feeling this is going to be my third Emmy.
Really? It was that good?
It was better than that. I mean, the whole night they would tell me about how hot this guy was, and I really didn't understand what they were talking about. Then I found out. He was so hot, he spontaneously combusted. Did you get a picture I sent you?
I did. Let me see it. Yep, that's one hot dude.
Dude, remember the FM flip those days, man? Remember FM station, bro? I do. Those were some badass times, Michael Duff. Badass times. Remember those chicks? Remember the hair, bro? You had that cool thing right here where it was all like shaved, and then you did the side thing, but you always kept it long and real. FM flip, bro.
Happy freaking birthday, dude!
I remember Barry from back in high school. He was a looker. Then he grew up and he moved away. Became a Hollywood star. You know, I don't want to give anything away, but I think he and I both know who all those romantic songs were about. Joey! Joey, stop hitting your brother! You want to write some more songs? Because I'm here. Happy birthday, you crazy fuck. Jimmy, I swear...
Michael Duff, I do not think people realize that we're like the same. We're so alike. It's like... Same person. Look at the... sports thing, you like that football team from Boston, and you know, I don't, but I like archery, which is very different, but they both involve projectiles through the air. You know, mine solo sport, yours team, but still, the movie, you know, you like all those epic war movies. Well, I don't really like the war part, more sci-fi, but it's still, it's theater. We share the love of theater. You love Cheerios. I like rice pudding, which is a base. Well, it's rice and that's oats. But, you know, it's the similarities are astounding, just astounding. In wishing you happy birthday, I wish myself happy birthday because we're one. We are Marla Duff or Michael Philiday. Same thing. Happy birthday.
Michael, honey, I'm at the Flower Mart, something that, you know, it's just a special occasion. It's not something I'm going to be doing all the time, you know, not like for every shower or every birthday. You know, you don't have to worry about it. I'm not the girl to go down to the Flower Mart and get flowers for everybody. No, just this one time. So anyway, I just want to know, could I put an extra $100 on the card? Okay, so I'm just you know what, it's winter, it's November. I might need 150. And you won't have to worry about me coming down here doing this anymore. That's it for me. Because this is a really special friend. You know, it's just for that one special friend. Okay, so maybe 200. Wow, look at those orchids.
Are you ticklish?
Yeah. Not really.
Do some multiplications.
Yeah. 42 herbs. 154.
So.
Traveling with me.